when, for me, it was when we, when I read things he was publishing that I began to really get the picture.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So that was through his writing that I think that he influenced his children particularly.
Mm-hmm. But Dad was always very subtle. He didn't try to teach you, now this is this, and trying to describe everything. If you asked him a question, what is that white fellow blooming over there? Then he would start asking you questions. Pretty soon you think, why did I ever bring it?
But I'd add one comment to that, that again, put yourself back in the 1930s. Leopold becomes a faculty member in 1933, in the depth of the Depression, yeah. And he now is also, among his other hats he's wearing, the extension agent, wildlife extension agent for the state of Wisconsin. And so part of his job is to communicate with farmers, average citizens, bird watchers, hunters, all kinds of different people. And that's when you really see this part of Leopold's communication style kick in. Having to realize it's not just a matter of, it's deeper than that, that in fact how to think about these big issues, go back to my talk, how to think about the complexity of human nature relationships and what that means for the economy, what that means for your community, that's a theme. Sometimes we'll talk about it explicitly, but sometimes it's just quietly embedded in very simple statements or articles or things he's doing or lectures he's giving. But the point is, he's talking to an audience that is average citizens of the state of Wisconsin and beyond. But that's a very different audience than the one he had been writing for up to then. And it really, plus that's all, these are also the years when the science of ecology is becoming mature. And he's one of the very few people who really sees the deep implications of this new science for traditional forestry or game management or soil conservation. So he's very much keenly interested in how do you communicate in this new and pretty unusual science to this generation of people so that they can take better care of the land. It's very pragmatic what he's doing at that
point. Curt, I can remember Dad going down to visit the next farm in Gilbert. And Dad said, sometimes he's just sitting on the edge of the bench and he's not just that.
Yeah.
And he didn't force it.
One of my favorite photos, it has a similar scene, you know, this photo I've been using a lot lately, it's one of my favorites. And it's Leopold with one of his graduate students in a barnyard, talking to a farmer and his son. And there's Aldo, and he's just kind of laid back, he's got a cigarette going. And they're just talking. It's a hot day, you can tell it's the mid-30s and a hot summer day, everyone's in their short sleeves. Just sitting there in the most relaxed way possible, just talking. And I like that photo so much because it says a lot about not just Leopold, it says a lot about sort of Wisconsin, what we like to think of here as the Wisconsin spirit of professors and citizens working together to solve problems. That's what defines our university system when it's at its best. And so I always appreciated that photo because it reveals so much personally as well as about the community at that time.